In today's video, we're going to take a look at keyboard navigation on the Mac. What is keyboard navigation? Well, let's go over to my Mac and take a look at what I'm talking about. When we're looking at the Mac, when I hit the Tab key, I'm going to hit the Tab key here. When I hit the Tab key, you're going to see that this focus will change. And what I mean by focus is you're going to see that there's a little outline there. So now when I hit the Tab key, what it's going to do is it's going to go to the next one here. And then it'll go down as I continue hitting the Tab key. So it's changing the focus. Okay, so that's kind of nice, but what can I do with this? Well, if I want to open up this AirDrop and Handoff, now what I do is I hit the space bar. Being that this is highlighted here, when I hit the space bar, what it's going to do is it's going to open that up. And then again, I can hit the Tab key to go through all of these different focuses here. You're going to see that it is going through and selecting all the different buttons here. So that is what keyboard navigation is. Basically, what it allows you to do is, in addition to your mouse and trackpad, you can also control your keyboard or control your Mac with your keyboard. Now, before I get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in making these videos. Okay, with that out of the way, let's take a look at keyboard navigation. Let's go over to my Mac. Now, in order to set this up, what we need to do is go over to our system settings here, system preferences if you're using an older Mac. This is an old setting. This is nothing new. I am using macOS Sequoia, but it is not a macOS Sequoia feature. This has been around for a long time. So what we need to do is we just need to go to our system settings. And then from here, we need to go to our keyboard. The keyboard is located at the very bottom. So I'm going to swipe up here, and then you're going to see keyboard here. This is where we need to go. So now I tap on it, or click on it, I should say. And then you're going to see an option. It's basically, we just turn it on and off. You're going to see an option for keyboard navigation. And all we have to do is just tap on the little slider here, and then it'll work. That's basically all we have to do. So when I turn this slider off, let's go ahead and do that. Now when I hit the Tab key, watch what happens. The focus isn't going to change. Yes, it's just switching between these two here, but it's not going through all of the different focuses or all of the different controls. But now when I turn it on, now when I hit the Tab key, watch what happens. The focus is going to change. It's going to go through all of the different settings. So it's looking at this right now. I'm going to hit the Tab key. Now we're looking at this. And if I want to change it, I can use the arrow keys. Or I can hit the Tab key. And now it goes over to the next focus. And I can hit the space bar to turn it on and off. So basically, I am able to change all of my settings without having to go to my mouse or to my trackpad, depending on what you use as an input device. Now, I actually use this in addition to my trackpad, of course. You can't go without using your trackpad or your mouse, but this does complement all of those different input devices. In addition to that, if you hit Shift-Tab, remember, Tab will go through all of the different controls here. So it's just going through all the different controls. You can see it here, going through all the different controls. But now, when I hit Shift-Tab, it goes backwards. So we can go back as well. Now, in addition to that, I'm going to tell you another little tip for keyboard navigation. Instead of hitting a cancel button, what you can do is hit Command period, and it'll cancel it. Let's see what I mean. Let's go and open up a save dialog box, just an open dialog box. I'm going to save a document where we're going to have a cancel. So let's go ahead and go back over to my Mac, and we're just going to go over to Pages here. It's just like Microsoft Word. I'm going to open up a new document once it opens here. Let's just go ahead and open up a new document. We'll just go with today's news. And now we have this today's news. So now what I would like to do is I would like to save this. So how do you do that? Well, you can hit Command S and it'll save it. I can go and name it here. And then I tap on save. It's a two-step process. But let's just say I wanted to cancel it. Maybe I don't want to save this. Well, one way of doing that, being that I'm using keyboard navigation, is hitting the Tab key right now. The focus is on this button here, but watch what happens. You're going to see that it is going through all of the different controls. And when I get to cancel, what I can do is I can tap on the space bar. Okay, that works kind of nice, but there's an easier way of doing it. As long as we have this cancel button here, what I can do is I can use command period, and it'll cancel it. So now I just hit command period, and you can see that it canceled it. Another way of doing that, let's go ahead and hit save again. Another way of doing that is just using the escape key. I hit the escape key, and the window disappears. So we don't always necessarily have to click on cancel. Also, with keyboard navigation, actually I think this is outside of keyboard navigation, when I do save a document, you're going to see that we have the save here. And this is highlighted, or it's orange, because that's what Pages makes it. In some apps, it'll be blue. Well, if I wanted to save this, all I have to do is just name it here. And I don't actually have to click on this. Don't click on it. Being that it is the orange button or blue button, it's the save button, what you're able to do is just hit return. That's what that color means. I can just hit return, and it'll save it under the name that I name it here. So basically, when you have a save dialog, an open save dialog box like this, what you can do when you have keyboard navigation is use the tab key to go through the different focuses. You can change folders, things like that. Also, what you can do is you can escape to get out of it. And once you name it, being that the save dialog or the save button is orange or highlighted, all you have to do is just hit return. You don't actually have to physically click on it. So that is keyboard navigation on the Mac. Basically, we just go and turn this on through our system settings. Go to the keyboard settings, and then you can go and turn it on. It's just a simple on and off. And once you do that, when you hit the tab key, you'll be able to change your focus and use the space bar to control the focus or turn on and off the control that the focus is on. I know it's a little odd terminology, focus and control, but that's what Apple calls it. But basically, we're just rotating through our different controls, and we use the space bar to turn it on and off. So that is how we use keyboard navigation on the Mac. And also, by the way, this is one of my favorite tips. So that's keyboard navigation on the Mac. Now, as I mentioned in the beginning, if you like this, how can you support my efforts in making these videos? Well, there's a few different ways. What you can do is you can subscribe to my channel, my YouTube channel. You can like the video. You can share it. You can click on the bell. You'll receive notifications when I release a new video. But in addition to that, you can also visit my site, danstutorials.com. On YouTube, I have about 400 videos, but on my site, I've been doing this a lot longer. On my site, I have over 2,100 videos, all related to Apple devices. And when you become a member of my site, you don't have to become a member, but when you do become a member of the site, you will no longer see any ads in the videos. You also get access to my online events. I host AMAs and classes on a regular basis. And then you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. So when you become a member, just know that you are helping support a small business. Anyway, check out danstutorials.com, and also that is how you use keyboard navigation on the Mac.